Stranger.
This must be the old growth. Shell said the hunting party was attacked near here. Best place to start looking for the hunter's seed pouches. Strange, I might trade for something good. Going down.
Thank you.
Sounds like someone's in trouble. Well, now they're alert.
No mercy!
Protect Riverhead!
Not let them through!
Save those smiles for your families. The Tanakh understand only strength, and ours was a poor display at best. They will be back. You, the one who actually won this fight for us. A word. I want everyone fortifying the pass.
Your warriors seem...
green as early spring. There are children playing with sticks. It's all I can do to keep them alive. It'll only get harder. So far, the rebels have sent mere scouts. But it won't be long till they return for an all-out assault. And if they bring machines with them, we'll need a lot more than eager hearts to win.
You seem to know a lot about Tanakh's tactics.
Back when the Tanakh clans pushed back the Karja raiders, I joined the fight.
The Tanakh taught you how to fight?
More than that. They taught me how to work with metal. I'm probably the only Lutaro who can. Never thought I'd be using what I learned then to fight against them now. We may speak freely here.
So, what's the plan?
The plan was making new weapons for my so-called fighters. I send my best climber, Voss, up the drum route to get the materials we need. Wide maws leave metal pods we use for crafting at its summit. But the derangement has made them as dangerous as the climb to reach them. Voss has yet to return. We have defenses to set up, and we are running out of time. If the Savior of Meridian is willing to lend us her strength a little longer, I believe you can get us what we need.
You know who I am.
Red hair, bow, fights better than 10 warriors put together. You're well known, and so is your little disagreement with the chorus.
I understand what this place means to your people, but you're outnumbered and under-equipped. You can leave, head to safety.
Have you ever seen a flower so small and white? When it falls, it looks like snow in spring. My daughter called them winter song. She carried their seeds to the day she drew her last breath. Now those seeds grow in the grove, at the heart of River Hem, planted by my own hands. As do the ones of every brother and sister taken from us during the Red Raids. I will not abandon them.
You know Zoe?
I knew the warrior who led the bravest of my tribe against the Karja. But the Zoe that came back from the rout spends too much time dwelling on things that just had to be done. I'm not one for regrets.
I'm sorry about your daughter.
The raids took her from me. I found my peace in every Karja that fell beneath my spear. Now all I have left of her is planted in the grove here. No Tanakhth will force me out.
Do all Utaru carry seeds with them?
We are given our pouches soon after we're born. When we die, the seeds are buried. A reminder that our deaths bring new life. It is how we remain one with the rhythm of the world.
What makes the path up to the drum root so dangerous?
It's a cave of sunken passages and gaping caverns that only the very skilled can navigate. It serves as a safe haven for my people, but machines have patrolled its deepest passageways ever since the derangement. Even so, River Hem and the Grove live off its waters. We are connected to it as much as we are to the seeds growing behind you.
What exactly do you do around here?
I am the metal weaver of River Hem. But all you really need to know about me is that I plan to keep my people alive. Thanks to you, we might actually have a chance at that.
Tell me more about these metal pots.
They are tricky to collect. The Widmars sow them. One must be quick enough to gather them before the soil and water take them. But their metal is among the sturdiest I've ever weaved. Without them, our chances of survival are slim.
Oh, if there's no convincing you to leave, I guess we're making some weapons.
You have my thanks. There's no time to waste. Follow me. This way. With those paws and a whole lot of luck, we just might get out of this alive. Let's hope these sprouts can hold their ground against a squad of machines. I can only cover so much ground, and my joints aren't what they used to be.
Looked to me like they chose to stay here as much as you did.
It'll be the fight of their lives, that's for sure. Almost there. This is the best we can do to hide those who cannot fight. But if we fall, the Tanakhth will find them sooner than later. We're here. This is it. Do you have any questions?
I'm ready.
Good luck. Come see me at the forge when you're done.
Plenty of menacing machines out there, Easterner.
You're still around?
Hope those nutrients are working out.
Guess I better start finding my way up to the top.
Thank you.
All right. Hey.
I need to find a way up there. I don't think I'm getting anywhere through here. There doesn't seem to be an easy way to climb in this cave. But if there's tunnels up here, there might be some underwater. Maybe they can lead me someplace with a path through these caves. Send this to my stash. I should take a seat pouch to cure it. It seems to mean a lot to the Atari. Whatever. Let's find a way up these caves. Neon green shine too often. Find those white moths. There they are. Those pods they're rejecting. They must be the ones Q needs. Looks like I can just pick them up once they fall to the ground. If I'm quiet enough. I can get them without the machines ever knowing I'm here. Got it.
I can override Burrogs now.
could stop one of its attacks if I break those. should do it. Better get back to Q with these.
Happy to see me? Entrance. I can make my way back to Riverhem from here. I got what you needed.
Not a moment too soon. Did you find Voss?
I brought his seed pouch back.
I pray it'll be the last I bury. But now I need to get the weapons ready.
Let's hope it'll be enough.
It'll have to be.